They risked their lives to help others in the Azana spa shooting.
And tonight they share their amazing stories with 12 News. 25 officers first on the scene received honors today. Tomorrow we'll learn more and new information about the shootings when Brookfield Police releases some of their records. New at 10, WISN 12 News, Terry Sater is live. And Terry, you spoke with some of the officers first on the scene.
The officers all talked about the importance of their prior training on the day of the shooting, about how officers from a half dozen departments all worked as one unit, rescuing the women who had been shot but had survived, about the horrors of what they saw once they got inside.
Water pouring out of the ceilings, sirens blaring, lights flashing from the fire alarms.
For the first time in public, Elm Grove Police Officer Phil Doney describes being one of the first officers to respond to the Azana Salon shootings, first helping one of four wounded women to safety, then looking for the gunman inside.
Obviously, there were people who were three bodies that were on the ground. They were there, they were obvious, and we had to pass by them, whether we wanted to or not, because we had to take control of that building. And until it was confirmed that he had shot himself, we believed that he was alive and well and willing to do more damage, and we weren't about to allow that to happen.
Officer Doney was joined in those first moments by a handful of other officers, including Waukesha County Sheriff Deputy Mike Dowd. I asked him to describe what he saw.
Things that I can't describe for you. It was that bad.
Deputy Dowd and two dozen other officers are credited with rescuing or evacuating 19 people.
It's an honor to know that you were actually able to help somebody. It's what we all say when we start the job, that we do it because we want to help somebody, and it's nice to know that you actually are able to.
Elm Grove Officer Sandra Brown held the perimeter at the front door and also gathered crucial information from witnesses. I asked her about the personal impact.
Makes you humble and appreciative for, again, wonderful officers that we work with. The community support is outstanding. And again, family and friends, because I'm going home. So are my partners.
I asked the officers what can be learned from what happened here. And again, they talked about the importance of training to confront a gunman. And they are all deeply impacted that women died here before they could respond. Live in Brookfield, Terry Sater, WISN 12 News.